So far we did several number systems. We started with the natural numbers and then went on to, let's write a bit of a summary here. We started with natural numbers, the counting numbers, yeah, starting from 0 or 1, and abbreviated the set of all natural numbers with that n. Then we did the integer numbers. So these were the natural numbers extended to the negative side with negative numbers as well, yeah? And that was z, or that, z. Then that's the set of all integer numbers. And then we did rational numbers, which are written as ratios or as fractions, like 1 over 3 or 2 over 4 or things like that. And the symbol for that was a Q with a bit thicker sidelines here. So that's a set of all rational numbers. Now, next we are going to do are called the real numbers. So the real numbers, again, like before, they contain all that was there before, plus something extra. So these real numbers contain all the rational numbers. Rational numbers contain all the integer. The integer contain all the natural numbers. So see, we are expanding more and more. And the symbol for the real numbers will be an R, like this. Right. Let's recall rational numbers. If you remember this, we had these, all the numbers from 0 to positive, 0 to negative infinity, and then we had, in between 0 and 1, we had like fractions like 1/2, 1/3, 1/4, yeah? So any fractions or any ratios of that you can write like that. And then we zoomed in like this. Yeah, you can, in between those fractions, you can find new fractions, and you can do that forever. Yeah. So that means in between any two rational numbers, you can find an infinite amount of other rational numbers. Yeah. And that was important because now we brought infinity into the realm of the normal numbers, the normal finite numbers. Yeah. So if I draw that. So say in between 1/12 and 1/6 here. You can find an infinite amount of more numbers. Yeah. In between 1/24 and 1/12 you can find infinite. And you can go as deep as you want, and in between any two rational numbers, you can find infinitely more rational numbers. Yeah. So the infinity has come into our range of sort of limited numbers, yeah. And let's first talk about a way how to write that fact that you can find infinitely many there. And that is the decimal writing, the decimal numbers. It's a special way of writing rational numbers. Yeah. So we're still at the rational numbers here. Yeah. And talking about a way how to write them. So, write rational numbers, rational numbers with decimal point, decimal point. Yeah, so say you have 1/2, yeah, you can write it like this, 1/2, yeah. I should keep doing this once differently, I heard. So, 1/2, you can write that also as 0.5, yeah. And what does that 5 after the decimal point mean? It means it is, that's zero here, it means it is a zero plus 5/10. 5/10. That is a way of writing a rational number. Yeah, because it's the first place to the right of the decimal point. That's written as tenths. Yeah. So if you have 0.9, this is equal to 0 plus 9/10. Yeah. So in that way you can express 10 different rational numbers with one digit to the right of the decimal point. From 0.1 to 0.9, yeah? 0.1 to 0.9. These are 10 rational numbers. Numbers. Now, many of you know that already. Nevertheless, it will be useful to recapitulate this because it will play a role with the next number system that we'll have. Now, what do you do if you want more? Then you can do this. 0.01 up to 0.99. Yeah, this gives you 100, actually 0.00, it's the first one. It gives you 100, that goes before, 100 rational numbers. Numbers. 100 distinct, yeah? And 0.01 is equal to 0 plus 1/100. Yeah, so if you have two decimal points, it's 100 that you are using there, yeah? So in the case of, let's take another one, 0.73 is 0 plus 73/100. Yeah? Clear. Yeah, and you can continue that forever. Yeah. So as long as you can write a number with a decimal point, it is a rational number. As long as one can write a number with decimal point point. And any amount of digits, any amount of digits, digits to the left or the right of the decimal point, amount of digits, it is a rational number. Now, watch, this sentence is very carefully constructed. As long as you can write it, it is a decimal a rational number. Because as long as you can write it, it is a limited amount of digits. You cannot write an unlimited amount of digits. What would happen if there was an unlimited amount of digits? Yeah. An unlimited amount of digits. Unlimited amount of digits. Then you could not write it anymore. No computer, nobody in the universe could write it. An unlimited amount of digits. Then it is a real number. You see again, as soon as we come into the infinity, we get real here. Nothing finite is real, real. It may be rational, intellectual, and all that, but reality starts with infinity. Reality starts with infinity. With infinity. Right? So, do these numbers exist? Exist? Yes. For example, you have heard a number that's called pi. The number pi is a real number. It's a real number. You know pi, to calculate a circle. Just recapitulate it quickly. So, I should be able to draw perfect circles here in that tool. Right? So imagine that's a perfect circle. And the circumference, here is the radius. The radius. Yeah. Radius and then along here is the circumference all the way around up to here, back to here. So that's the circumference, and when that circle is perfect, then the circumference, let's call it C, and radius, let's call it r, then the circumference is 2 times pi times r. Yeah, so r is the radius from the center to the circumference, and circumference is the length of that circumference. And you can exactly calculate the length of that circumference 2 times pi times r. And pi is a real number. Now, pi is real and cannot be written with any amount of finite digits. So you can start writing pi. Yeah, 3.14 4, 1, 5, 9, 2, 6, 5, 3, 5. That's how far I'd remembered it. But you can do that to any amount of digits. Yeah, you can calculate that to millions and billions of digits, and it will never end. So this never ends, yeah? And how do we know? We have calculated it. Mathematicians have calculated it to a very long extent. How do you calculate that? There are methods to find that out. Yeah, there are methods to slowly get more and more of those digits out. Yeah, mathematical methods. And you can be sure that they are correct. So pi is written as a decimal. It's a never-ending decimal. It goes on for infinity. And it's a real number. And there are many other numbers like that. Yeah, like 2 times pi is also a real number. 3 times pi is also real. A half of pi. Yeah, things like that. Any multiples of pi are also written with never-ending decimal digits. Yeah, nobody ever was able to write it all because it's infinite. Yeah, so that's the nature of real numbers. Now, let's say that's the nature of most real numbers, of almost 100% of the real numbers. And there's almost 0% of the real numbers who are of the type of rational numbers. Yeah, let's draw that a bit on another number line. So what did I mean here? Let's draw a number line. So here we have got a number line going to plus infinity. 0 here. Minus infinity there. Minus infinity. And let's look at between 0 and 1. You can also do 1 and 2, 2 and 3. You can look at any place. But for simplicity, let's look between 0 and 1. Yeah. Then you know you have got 1 half here, rational number, written as a ratio. Yeah. You have got 1 quarter here, rational number. Yeah. Then we said in between any of those, you can have an infinite amount of other rational numbers. Yeah, as we zoom in, yeah, when we zoom in, then we can find more and more rational numbers. I can never draw it. It's an infinite amount of them. Yeah. But what's the difference to real numbers? Each one of those rational numbers. Yeah, let's make 1/8 here. 1/8. Each one of them can be written as a ratio of numbers with a limited amount of digits. Yeah, so I can write them. Whereas a non-rational real number cannot be written down because it has an infinite amount of digits. Yeah, I could not write it there. I could, you know, at some point I could write pi, yeah, could just say pi, but I could not write it as decimals. So real numbers numbers can be written let's call it with a finite approach. Yeah. Let's say 7/8. No, rational numbers. Sorry, not real. Rational numbers. Let's erase that. Rational numbers can be written like that. Rational. And like this, yeah, or a limited number of decimal digits. But in between any two rational numbers, there is an infinite amount of other rational numbers. Yeah? So let's choose that. Say, we choose an interval here. Say we choose this interval here. Then we know for sure in there is an infinite amount of rational numbers. So here comes our infinity first time, in between filling up all those places in between. Yeah. Yet every rational number is just a line here, or you can say just a dot here. Yeah, you can write it as dots here. So really that representation as a number line is not correct for rational numbers. Rational numbers are really dot, 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 dots. The line has empty spaces in between. Yeah, for rational numbers. Yeah, that's the disadvantage of ratio. Yeah, so it's an intellectual thing. It's like if you want to grasp everything with your intellect, you believe it's infinitely big, but it's infinitely hollow in between. You can't create a number line from it. First time you can create a number line, which is called the continuum. I write that. So let's go back. First time you can create a number line is with the real numbers. So this time it is really a line, that means a continuum. That's the mathematical term. And the continuum means that this line has no empty points in between, no hollows in between. It's completely filled up. It also means that the individual numbers, yeah, which are represent as points on that line, that most of the number points are infinitely long. Infinitely fine. Infinitely fine. Yeah. Represented by an infinitely long. Represented by an infinitely long decimal. Infinite long decimal. What's the difference to the rational numbers? The difference is not only that in between any two real numbers you have an infinite amount of other real numbers, but each one of them has infinity in it. So it's really intense infinity in there. Yeah? And then you have a few remaining non-infinite numbers, which are the rational numbers, which you also allow on here. So you allow like rational numbers like 1 or 2, you also allow on here. But they are so few compared to the infinitely long ones that if you take a ratio, those rational numbers on that dense continuum, if you take how much percentage are rational, how much percentage are real, the percentage of rational is 0%. So you have come to a level where you notice all that you thought was all real and all that stuff, it wasn't real. The reality is that infinity is 100%. Finite is 0%. So, you know, mathematicians like to go to the extremes, yeah. And we'll compare that later to what that means in your consciousness, you know, because that's the start of higher states of consciousness here. And we'll explain that in a later video. So, there will be a few more number systems to go through, and then we'll go to this correlation to higher states of consciousness. And hope to see you soon in the next video.